Hello students, today we'll start with the third factor that affect demand of an individual. So the third factor that affect demand of an individual is income of the consumer. We denote it as capital Y. So income of the consumer also affect demand of a commodity, keeping other factors as constant. It means that price of the commodity will be constant, price of related good will be constant, future expectations in change in price will be constant, taste and preference of the consumer will be constant. So everything apart from income of the consumer will be constant, then only it will be applicable. So before going ahead with it, we have to know there are two types of a commodity. Either a commodity will be an inferior good or it will be a normal good. The commodity will be either an inferior good or a normal good. So what are inferior good? So this concept change from person to person. I mean to say that for a person a good can be an inferior good, but for some other person that good maybe is not an inferior good but a normal good. Inferior good means which are low in quality, whereas a normal good is a commodity which is, in comparison to this, higher in quality. So you have to keep this in mind that which kind of commodity is being given in the question, or when you are explaining this factor as an factor which affect the individual demand, you should consider these two of goods, two types of good while explaining them. So when we differentiate between the two goods, as I've told you earlier, कि किसी एक person के लिए वो एक commodity normal हो सकती है, वो दूसरे के लिए inferior भी हो सकती है. So whenever we are taking that particular individual, we are considering his preference. Whenever there is an increase in income of the consumer, he always try to get more of the higher quality, which is the normal good, than what he used to consume. So that concept you have to keep in mind while discussing or while explaining this topic. So the differences between the two goods, inferior good and normal good, is that we assume that X is an inferior good which is being consumed by consumer Y with the particular given income. If there is an increase in income of the consumer, he will try to shift to a normal good. Let's assume that as Z. So whenever there is increase in income of the consumer will try to shift towards a normal good. That is the basic difference between inferior good and normal good, and that is the psychology of a consumer while he consumes the good. Whenever there will be an decrease in consumer's income, he will again shift to the inferior good which he or she used to consume earlier. So whenever there will be an increase in income of the consumer, he'll try to shift more to the normal good. Whenever there is a decrease in income of the consumer, he'll again shift towards the inferior good. That is the basic concept of these two goods. Now let's discuss them separately, like what will be the effect of change in income of the consumer for a normal good and what will be the effect of change in income of the consumer for an inferior good. So we'll take the normal good first as A, effect of change in income of the consumer for a normal good. So now I have written over here that change in income. So change in income can either be an increase in income or it will be a decrease in income. So we have two aspects for change in income for a normal good. So as I've told you earlier, whenever there is increase in income of the consumer, then there will be a rightward shift in the demand curve, which means that with an increase in income, the consumer will start demanding more of the normal good. Yani there will be an increase in demand of normal good. So it is clear by here that there is a direct relationship for a normal good. Whenever there is increase in income of the consumer, there will be an increase in demand for a normal good, and there will be a rightward shift in the demand curve. Okay, so we'll discuss that shift in demand curve after discussing decrease in income on the graph. So whenever there is increase in income of the consumer, there will be increase in demand for normal good, and there will be a rightward shift in the demand curve. So there is a positive relationship between increase in income and demand for the normal good. Let's talk about what will happen if there is decrease in income. For again, we are considering the normal good here. Okay. So whenever there is decrease in income of the consumer, there will be decrease in demand of normal good. And due to decrease in demand of normal good, there will be a leftward shift in the demand curve. Now the question arises, why is it so? Why, when there is increase in income, the demand for normal good also increases? When there is decrease in income, the demand of normal good decreases. Why is it so? So it is basically, if you remember, we have talked about Giffen goods, in that it was mentioned, it is basically the psychological aspect of the consumer. When the consumer is having enough money, he or she will try to consume more of a better good. Because of that, a normal good means a better good. So because of that, whenever there is increase in income of the consumer, consumers start consuming more of a better good, because now that good is affordable for him or her. Whereas whenever there is decrease in income of the consumer, they are not able to consume, or they are not able to afford that normal good or that better good. So they reduce the quantity demanded, they reduce the demand of the commodity for normal good. So that is the basic psychology of a consumer for normal good. Let's discuss these two on the demand curve. the price of the good X is 10 and the demand of good X is say 15. Now again the price of the good is 10 but the demand of the good increases from 15 to 20 and the reason for this increase increase in income of the consumer. So as the income of the consumer increases, what will happen? He tends to buy more of the normal good. So in the demand curve, so on the x-axis we are taking quantity of the commodity demanded and on the y-axis we are taking price of the good. So at rupees 10 the earlier or the initial demand was 15, so the demand curve was like this. Okay, as income of the consumer increases, the demand for normal good also increases from 15 to 20. So we have it like at this point. So the new demand curve will be this, B1. So you can see that there is a rightward shift in the demand curve from DD to D1. This is due to increase in income of the consumer. The price of the good is constant over here, but income of the consumer increases. Due to that, the demand for normal good also increases from DD to D1. Now, what if the income of the consumer decreases? So again, if we take 10 as price, the demand can be like say 10. So due to decrease in income of the consumer, there will be decrease in demand for normal good from 20, we'll rub this out now, from 20 to 10. Now the initial one, we can refer it as 20 or we can refer it as 15. Let's take 15 one. So if the situation is this, the initial demand was 15 at price 10 and there is decrease in the income of the consumer, the demand for that commodity also decreases from 15 to 10. So now the demand curve will be here. That is D2. So you can see that the demand curve shift from DD to D2, and this is the leftward shift due to decrease in income of the consumer. So here you can write also rightward shift due to increase in income of the consumer and leftward shift. The reason is decrease in income of the consumer. So I hope this is clear to you. So in normal good, there is a direct relationship between income of the consumer and demand of the normal good. When income of the consumer increases, demand for normal good also increases. When income of the consumer decreases, demand for normal good also decreases. So let's talk about the next aspect or the next good, that is inferior good. What will happen if we have inferior good with us and there is change in income of the consumer?